All right, Shalom, Makim. First and foremost, I want to give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashem, Rekha Kodash. I want to give double honors to the apostles at Great Millstone, and Shalom to the elect that teach this word in our true faith and sincerity. And today, I just want to title this lesson, Biblical Proportions. Biblical Proportions. And the subtitle is 200 million missiles, because you're going to it. The judgment of America is going to be of a biblical proportion, man. You know, it's not going to be of a volcano, because why? There's plenty of times where, as you can, for an example, Pompeii, that place was destroyed by a volcano, which that's a pretty common thing on an island, small island, or whatever the case may be. A volcano is going to cause some type of havoc. But those 200 million missiles is going to be something that that you ain't going to be able to forget, man. When, you know, the ones that do pass, you know, get through that second death, you know, because it's going to be a biblical proportion, just how Egypt was. It's still being mentioned today. People still doing documentaries and everything, you know, research about the plagues of Egypt and the splitting of the sea and all that, man. The Gulf, all that is still being talked about today, man. But why? Because it was of a biblical proportion. It was some to what's the word? That's going to stick to your mind. You know what I mean? And that's how the Lord, Yahweh Shem Shai, got his glory. Is through the judgment of Egypt, man. And the Lord's going to glorify again his name through the judgment of America. By the way, of these thermonuclear missiles, man. Which is going to be 200 million of those. So, before I get into this lesson, I got biblical proportions already lined up of biblical proportions. So, and it's out of yourdictionary.com, and it says of or pertaining to a natural disaster or a cataclysmic event so immense that it brings to mind biblical accounts of horrific catastrophes. So, dealing with biblical proportions, you got to understand one thing. There is nothing good that comes out of that. There is nothing good that's going to come out of the biblical proportion. It says something so immense that it brings to mind biblical accounts of horrific catastrophes, man. Horrific catastrophes. Because when you see this place, America, being hit with those missiles, man, it's going to be a horrific sight for you people, man. Which is going to be beautiful to us, the whole elect, man. Lord, we're part of that number. That's going to be a beautiful sight, man. Because the thing is, we're going to be able to see what Lot didn't see. We're going to be able to see the destruction of spiritual Sodom, man. You know, because Sodom and Gomorrah and the other five cities, they was hit with fire and brimstone. But Lot was commanded not to look back. This time, we're going to be able to see the judgment. Matter of fact, before I get the next definition, let me just get that in Psalm, just to, you know, bring it out, man. You know, because we're going to be able to see the reward of the wicked, man. So this is on Psalms 91 and 8. It says, only with thine eyes. Matter of fact, I'm going to start it up. I'm gonna start at the top. You know, it says, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my power, in him will I trust. Surely he shall deliver me from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. And what's that's the nuclear missiles, man. You know, I think it's Judges, Phil Chatter said, the noise of the archers, which lets you know that that's talking about the missiles. Because when you hunting, a bow and arrow is a silent weapon. at least with a sword, you can hear the sword cutting the air, you know. But with an arrow, it cuts through the wind, man. You can't hear it, and that's what you know. You hunt was with the bow and arrow, so you know, whatever you hunt, it won't hear that, you know, your weapon, man. That bow and arrow, that's a silent weapon. So the arrows that they're going to be shot now is going to be very noisome, man. Which is those missiles. It says, he shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shall thou trust. And then that's talking about the chariots, man. It says, his truth shall be thy shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid by the terror, for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that fly by day. That's those missiles, man. It says, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasteth at noonday. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee. Only with thine eye shalt thou behold and see the reward of the wicked. So when we're getting beamed up, we're going to see that glass mingle with fire, man. That the sea mingle with glass of fire, that those missiles, man. Gonna be able to see the destruction of America by the way of those thermonuclear missiles, those 200 million missiles, because that's the only way to escape it is by the chariots, man. You know, and hey man, guys that think there's gonna be volcanoes, I mean, you guys are finished, man. Because hey, what it is in Yellowstone, that's in Washington, it's gonna be 2 or 3 weeks before you even get to the Midwest, man. For the lava and everything, get to the middle, even if it lasts that long. So you guys, man, if you want America to be destroyed, you want it to be a destruction, man. You want to be a destruction, man. And it's going to be by the way of those thermonuclear missiles, you know. It's going to be a biblical proportions. Why? Because it's going to be 200 million of those, you know. So continuing on his definition. It says figuratively, by extension, or of by extension, of or pertaining to a thing of occurrence having vast size, extent, or consequences. So yeah, though, because the Lord's army is a large army, man. Is those missiles, man? That's the Lord's army. Is those 200 million missiles, man? Is having vast size. Because the sky is going to be darkened, and you people are going to bug out when you see it, man. Why? Because they're not going to bump into each other. Matter of fact, before I get into it, let me just get the number, and then we'll just go on from there. Okay, cause this is Revelation 9 and 16. It says, and the number of the army of the horsemen were 200,000,000. And I heard the number of them. So 200 million. And it says, and thus I saw the horses in the vision, and in them that sat on them, having breastplates of fire, and of jacinth, and of brimstone. And the heads of the horses were as the heads of lions, and out of their mouths issued fire and smoke and brimstone. Yeah, because the head is the head of the lion. That's where the power, that's where the power is at. Those war heads, man. The warheads, you know, everything else is the rest of the body is meant to project it over to its target, but that last little piece of the missile, the head of the missile, is where the power is at. That's why it says the heads of lions, man. You know, and it says by these three was the third part of men killed by the fire and by the smoke and by the brimstone was issued out of their mouths. So that's talking about those missiles, man. Because you gotta understand who the third part of men is, man. Esau. And you gotta understand this too. How about Shemel Shai? You gonna reap what you sow, man. You know. So how did America get a full grip on the earth, man? How was America really established as a superpower? You know. Like, really, man. That's World War II, man. When they dropped that nuclear bomb. The atom bomb on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. The atom bombs. And that's how, but you Edomites, Esau Edom, that's how you're going to be taken out too, man. You firmly had a grip on the world with those missiles. And guess what? That's going to be the thing that's take you out too as well, man. So this is Proverbs 26 and 27. It says, whoso diggeth a pit shall fall therein, and he that rolleth a stone, it will return upon him. And the scripture says in Psalms 10, let him be taken in the device that he have imagined. So you Edomites, man, those missiles are coming back to you, even though you use that to it's like you use that to gain power to earth. Because what's your main focus on these other nations, such as Korea? Denuclearization, man. Why? Because you know the other nations have the power of the missiles now, and you don't want that because you know you stepped on these other nations' toes, and they ready to push the button on you guys, man. You know, but continuing on the biblical proportions, because you people are going to be bugged out, man. When you see those missiles in the air, man. Let's see. I just started at the top. This is Joel 2:1. It says, blow ye the trumpet in Zion, and sound the alarm on my holy mountain. Let all the inhabitants of the land tremble, for the day of the Lord cometh, for it is nigh at hand. So they let you know that the day of the Lord, the day of Yahweh Shemayah, is a terrible day, man. Because it says you let the inhabitants of the land tremble, so you know that the Lord coming, you should be in fear, man, because it's not going to be a rose petals and you know, in Hud's day, man. It's going to be a day of destruction. You know, it says a day of darkness and of gloominess, a day of clouds and of thick darkness, as the morning spread upon the mountains, a great people and a strong, there not have ever been the light, neither shall be any more after it, even to the years of many generations. So yeah, and then you come out, and if you want to say the Edomites are done away with, well, who is these great people that's going to be there and not going to be there after that, man? You know, they let you know it's going to be the missiles, because there have not ever been a light, which, you know, you had the atom bombs, but those nuclear bombs are way above those atom bombs, man. And after they're being used, it won't be no use for those weapons no more, man. It won't be no more war, because Israel is going to be on top, man. We're going to be in our own land again, man. Everything's going to be ruling in righteousness, man. We ain't going to have no wars, nothing like that, man. So that's why it's not going to be any more after it, man. It's not going to be no use for no missiles, man. You know, it says a fire devoured before them, and behind them a flame burned them. So who are these people? They got fire before them and flame behind them, man. And you say angels. Just talking about the Lord's army, those nuclear missiles, man. It says the land is as the Garden of Eden before them, and behind them a desolate wilderness. Yeah, and nothing shall escape them. So yeah, once those missiles hit ground zero, before they hit, you see life, so to speak. You know, you know, just say if the missiles hit, before it hit a city or something, it's like the Garden of Eden. You got life going on. But once they hit, and you come back to where the ground, you know, ground, it's like ground zero, it's a desolate wilderness, man. There's nothing there, man. And it says nothing shall escape them, because that radius, which in America, you ain't any place in America that when those missiles are being shot over here, man, any place in America that you are at, the only way we're going to be able to escape is by those thermonuclear missiles, man. It's like it by the only way we're going to be able to escape those thermonuclear missiles is by those chariots. You know, the only way we're going to be able to escape those missiles is to go straight up to the heavens, man. By the way of those chariots. That's why it says nothing shall escape them, because it's going to lay out the whole land, man. Just like it for the tongue twister. But it says, continuing on in verse 4, it said the appearance of them is as the appearance of horses, and as horsemen so shall they run. And that's going back to Revelation 9 chapter, man. Talking about the horsemen again, man. Which, lets you know that a horse is a representation for power. You know, and that's what the Edomites, that's how they got their power, a strong, firm grip on the earth is by those missiles, man. And that's how they're going to be taken out. It says, like the noise of chariots on the top of mountains, so shall they leap. Like a noise of a flame, of a fire that devoured the stubble, as a strong people sit in battle array. Before their face, the people shall be much pain. All face shall gather blackness. So yeah, you people are going to be much pain. And you're going to be messed up, man. You're going to be messed up, man. Because you're going to see 200 million missiles coming to the land of America. And guess what? They're not going to bump into each other. It's going to be a perfect... what's the word I'm looking for? It's like it. It's going to be a perfect lineup, man. It manifest is going to continue on and continue on. It says, they shall run like mighty men. They shall climb the wall like men of war, and they shall march everyone in his way, and they shall not break their run. So they're going to be lined up where they're supposed to be. There's none that's going to bump into each other, man. It says, neither shall one thrust another. They shall walk everyone in his path, and when they fall upon the sword, they shall not be wounded. So, hey, man. I want to see when they turn, you know, these guys that's immortal, that just going on just killing shit. Nah, I ain't talking about that. That's talking about these missiles, man, because though your missile defense system is not going to work, which that is proven now, because they have done multiple tests and slowed it down so many percent, over 50%, 60%, and they still missing, man. So imagine when these missiles go on full blast, 200 million of them. You know, hey man, it ain't no way you can stop this, man. You know, and it's going to be of a biblical proportion. Why? It's because it's going to be, everything is going to be lined up perfectly, man. The Spirit of the Lord is going to be in those missiles, man. You know, and that's why you people are going to be messed up. Why? Because once you see that, once you see those missiles, you got 2 minutes to think about things. You know, it says, once you see those missiles, it's 2 minutes to hit ground zero. So you people are going to be much pain. A lot of people going to have heart attacks. And the Lord is going to keep that spirit in you, man, till them missiles hit, man. You know? So yeah, this is Isaiah 13. And one, it said, the burden of Babylon, which Isaiah the son of Amos did see, lift ye up a banner upon a high mountain, exalt the voice unto them, shake the hand that they may go into the gates of the nobles. I have commanded my sanctified ones, I have also called my mighty ones for my anger, even them that rejoice in my highness. The noise of a multitude in the mountains, like as a great people. See, it's talking about that great people again, man. And that's how you get, and that's how the Lord, he's a stumbling block, man. You gotta really take your time and precept upon precept, because you keep on, you will think it's talking about a people, man. But it's talking about those nuclear missiles. You know, it says, a tumultuous noise of the kingdoms of nations gathered together. The Lord of hosts mustered the host of the battle. Yeah, and you gotta understand this. The Lord of hosts, man. And that's throughout the scriptures. And what the word host means. Army. Matter of fact, I think I got the blue letter. Let me get that in. Just cause you people, you can just say Lord of hosts, and you will just you know, just go over that word, man. But you gotta understand the word host means armies, man. So let's see, let's get this, it says that which goes forth, army, war, warfare, host, army, host, host of organized army, host of angels, of sun, moon, stars, of whole creation, war, warfare, service, go out to war, service. So yeah, he's a lord of the armies, man. It says a organized army. You know, because those missiles are going to be very organized when they hit America. Each missile got his own target to hit, man. Each missile got its own little target it's going to hit. And it's 200 million, man. Which it is biblical, because people, you think that, you know, some people, you know, well, if you believe in the Bible, everyone knows that it talks about a third world war. And what is the vibration of the third world war? It's a nuclear war, man. Matter of fact, go back to Isaiah 9:5. It says, for every battle of the warrior is with confused noise and garments rolled in blood. So yeah, back then during the ancient times, when you were going to war, I like to say you get down and dirty, which means you know you using your sword, you screaming, yelling, you got swords hitting shields, you know, you getting bloody. That's confused noise when the swords hitting the shields, swords hitting swords. You might hear a bone crackle. That's the confused noise. And garments rolled in blood means you're going to get bloody, man. It's a face-to-face type of thing, man. You know, but it says, but this shall be with burning and fuel of fire. So, yeah, this battle right here is going to be with burning and fuel of fire. So, that lets you know this is a third world war. It's going to be a nuclear war, man. You know, World War One, you know, you had your glittering swords. Or two, you had it. But this one right here, they're going to skip all that. And they're just going to hit the button, man. And use those missiles, man. You know. So go back to Isaiah 13. In verse 5, it says, they come from a far country, from the end of heaven, even the Lord and the weapons of his indignation to destroy the whole land. See, so they come from a far country, they from the end of heaven. So they're coming from an aerial view, man. They're coming, it's an aerial attack. You know, they come from the end of heaven, which lets you know it's going to be an aerial attack, man. Which that's how Esau get down anyway. If he ain't getting his way, first thing he do is send an airstrike, man. You know, matter of fact, let's get this in 2 Ezra 16 and I think it's 13, I believe. Yeah, this 2 Ezra 16 and 13 says, for strong is his right hand that bendeth the bow, his arrows that he shooteth are sharp and shall not miss. When they begin to be shot into the ends of the world. And you got to know that this is a parabolic book, man. A lot of things you can't take literally. A lot of things is figuratively. And what is those arrows figuratively to? Those missiles, man. Because it's not possible for anyone to shoot an arrow from one end of the world to the other, man. You know? So that lets you know that's talking about those missiles. He come from a far country, man. To the ends of the world, which is here in the west. Because the beginning of the world starts on the east. And the end of the world ends in the west. So just how, like the Hebrew, when you write the Hebrew, you write from right to left, man. You know, that's how it is. It's from right to left. So the east, those missiles gonna come from the east, by the way, Russia, the EU, all the other nations, and it's gonna be shot over here to the west, man, America. You know, it says, behold, the plagues are sent and shall not return again until they come upon the earth. So once you hit those missiles, man, and once they go out their silos, that's it. You can't stop that, man. You know, so let's go back to Isaiah 13:5 again. It says, they come from a far country, from the end of heaven, even the Lord in the witness of his indignation to destroy the whole land. So Yahweh Shemiah was shy. The weapons of his indignation is those missiles, man. They come from a far country, man. That's the east, and it's coming all the way to the west. It said to destroy the whole land. So once those missiles hit, it's going to destroy the whole land. It says, "How ye, for the day of the Lord is at hand. It shall come as a destruction from the Almighty." So the Lord, he's taking responsibility that destruction is coming, and it's coming from him, man. And who is he sending it to? America, man. Really, you Edomites as a whole, your whole system is going down, man. And the icing on the cake is these missiles, you know. So, yeah, Aki, man, I just hope they were edifying. Until the next time, I'm going to say Shalom.